الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، نبينا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا محمد بن عبد الله، عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم، ما بعد. فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وقال تعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، ولله الأسماء الحسنى فادعوه بها، وذروا الذين يلحدون في أسمائه سيجزون ما كانوا يعملون. صدق الله العظيم. All praise and thanks be to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer and nourisher. May the choicest of his blessings and salutations be upon our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions and all those who tread on his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, we gather after some time, so we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he shower his mercy upon us, and he makes this gathering a gathering where the angels shroud us with their wings, the sakina, tranquility of Almighty Allah descends upon us, and may he unite us just as how we are united here in the gardens of Jannah. In today's session, inshaAllah, we'll be discussing a kalima, a word like none other. Like none other. It is such a great word that there are no words, I can't find words to express myself on how I'm going to explain this to you. It's such a great word. And what is that word? It is known as the Lafzul Jalalah, the most greatest word ever, ever. And we have the Ismullah Al-A'zam, which we already discussed, the greatest name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which has specific qualities and attributes. But now in regard to words, Al-Kalima, this word is the greatest, and it is known as Lafzul Jalalah. Don't confuse yourself with Ismullah Al-A'zam and Lafzul Jalalah. The Lafzul Jalalah is none other than Allah. Allah. Such a great word. We don't think of it. Just sit and think. Allah. How many times you say this word for a day? You tell your takbir for salah. Allahu Akbar. Allah is the most greatest. Allah. Our creator, our sustainer, our nourisher, our protector. The one who brought us into existence. So this is known as Lafzul Jalalah, the greatest word. This word is mentioned 2,698 times in the Noble Quran. It is mentioned 2,698 times in the Noble Quran. And it is the primary name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah Himself says in the Quran, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى. To Allah belongs the most beautiful of names. So we don't say that Allah comes from Ar-Rahman, or that the word Allah comes from Ar-Rahim. But rather it's the other way around. Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Al-Malik, Al-Muhaymin, Al-Aziz, Al-Jabbar, Al-Mutakabbir. All of these names come from the primary source, the fountainhead, which is Allah. Which is the name Allah. So my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, in the Hebrew language, it is known as Elohim and Eloha. The same thing in the Arabic language, Allah. So scholars differ. Two mainstream opinions, that this word Allah, has it been derived from something? Or else, is it an ism jamid, a proper noun, which is not derived from anything? For example, you take the name As-Sami'. Allah is the all-hearing. That name has been derived from Sami'a Yasma'u, which means to hear. Allah is Al-Basir. That is also derived from the verb Al-Basr, which means to see. So likewise, all many names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are derived from roots. So scholars differ whether Allah, the name Allah, has also been derived as such. So some scholars say no. Allah is an ism jamid. It has not been derived from anything. It's a proper noun. You can't derive anything from that. It is the name of Allah and that's it. End of the quote. And another group of scholars, they say no. Allah is derived from Aliha Ya'lahu in the Arabic language. Aliha Ya'lahu, which means to worship. Aliha Ya'lahu. So Allah is the worshipped one. Allah is the worshipped one. So these are the two opinions in regard to the name Allah, from where it came from. Likewise, we see the word Allahumma in all of our adu'iyah, in all of our du'as. Allahumma inni as'aluka ilman nafi'an. Allahumma anta as-salam wa minka as-salam. Tabarakta ya dhal jalali wal ikram. All of our adu'iyah, we begin with, all of our du'as, we begin with Allahumma. So what does Allahumma mean? It means Ya Allah. The word Allahumma means Ya Allah. So we are addressing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I think I mentioned in the last session that in regard to Ismullahi al-Azam, the greatest name of Allah, scholars differ there too. Some say Al-Hayyul Qayyum and some say Allah. For all of the names are connected to this fountainhead. So naturally they say, scholars such as Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, they mention that Allah has to be the greatest name. The name by which if you pray with it, if you invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with it, your dua will never be rejected by Allah. Allahu Akbar. So my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, the word Allah, ismun li sahibihi kullu jalal. Allah, the one whom all glory belongs to. Allah, ismun li sahibihi kullu jamal. Allah, to whom all beauty belongs to. Allah, ismun li sahibihi kullu kamal. Allah, to whom all perfection belongs to. Allah, huwa al-ismu alladhi ma dhukira fil qalili illa kathara. Allah, the one who brings about an increment, a profit, an abundance at times where there is loss, when there is a decrement. Allah huwa al-ismu alladhi ma dhukira 'inda al-khawfi illa amana. Allah, he is the one who brings safety, he is the one who brings protection at the time of khawf, at the time of fear, at the time of distress. Allah huwa al-ismu alladhi ma dhukira 'inda karbin illa farraja. Allah, he is the one who brings a way out at the time of misfortune, at the time of calamities. Allah huwa al-ismu alladhi ma dhukira 'inda hammin illa kashafa. Allah, he is the one who removes all types of anxieties, all types of worries. Allah huwa al-ismu alladhi ma dhukira 'inda dhiqin illa wasa'a. Allah, he is the one who opens paths, makes ways at times of constraint, at times of difficulty. Allah huwa al-ismu alladhi ma ta'allaqa bihi faqirun illa aghna. Allah, he is the one who enriches a poor and destitute soul. Allah huwa al-ismu alladhi ma ta'allaqa bihi mareedun illa shafan. Allah, he is the one who brings about a complete cure for the one who is sick. He is the cure. Allah huwa al-ismu alladhi ma ta'allaqa bihi mudarr illa nasarahu wa awan. Allah, he is the one who helps. He is the one who supports the one who is in hardship. Allah huwa al-ismu alladhi ma ta'allaqa bihi dhalilun dha'ifun illa a'azzahu wa qawwam. Allah, he is the one who strengthens. He is the one who honors someone who is dhalil, who is weak, who is low. He is the one who brings them up. Allah huwa al-ismu alladhi tustantaru bihi ar-rahamat. It is Allah who rains down His mercy upon us. Allah huwa الذي هو الاسم الذي تستمتر به البركات. It is Allah who rains down His blessings upon us, His barakat upon us. Allah huwa الاسم الذي تستجلب به الحسنات. It is Allah who rains down upon us all types of good. Allah huwa الاسم الذي تدفع به السيئات. It is Allah who wards away all types of evil away from us. هو الاسم الذي قامت به الأرض والسماوات. He is the one who maintains, who runs the seven heavens and the seven earths. Allahu Akbar. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, a narration once, a hadr min ahbar al-Yahud, a Jewish scholar, a rabbi, once comes to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He comes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he asked Rasulullah, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is mentioned in our scriptures, he is a Jewish scholar, it is mentioned in our scriptures that your God, that your Allah, on one finger of His, He has the seven heavens. And another finger of His, He has the seven earths. And another finger of His, He has the trees and the mountains and etc. And another finger of His, He has the waters, the oceans. And as this Jewish scholar kept on saying this, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the narration, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he smiles. He smiles to the extent that his teeth are visible. He smiles. And then he says, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ سبحانه وتعالى عما يشركون. The Jewish scholar, he's saying, seven heavens are on one finger, seven earths are on another finger, and he's going on saying about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah says, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِ. They haven't appraised Allah, a true appraiser. They haven't appraised Allah, a true appraiser. وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. All of the seven earths, all of this will be in the grip of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment, on the day of Qiyamah. وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِ. Seven heavens will be folded in the right hand of Almighty Allah. سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. Glory be to Allah. Glory be to Allah, and He is far above, high above all of that which they associate unto Him. All of these idols, all of whatever they associate unto Allah, Allah is high above all of that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says this and concludes the hadith. So my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, in regard to who is Allah? Who is Allah? None can answer this question, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, other than Allah Himself. For Allah is the one, He says in the Quran, شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو. Allah is the one who witnessed His own oneness the first. He was the first person to witness His own oneness. Before the Malaika, before the Ulul Ilm, before all of them, Allah Himself says, La ilaha illa hu. There is no deity worthy of worship other than Himself. It is Allah Himself. So it is Allah who can describe Himself beautifully, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. For if we were to try and imagine Allah, if we were to try and imagine Allah, our minds are futile. Our little minds can never ever perceive, can never ever encompass Allah the Almighty. For even if we were to try, it will be a sin. Because we cannot associate to Allah those colors that we have in our mind, those imaginations that are within our futile mind. We can never ever try to imagine Allah. Allah save us. We might even become like those who make tashbih of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who compare Allah to His creation. Allah save us all. So all we can do is we can ponder, we can reflect on the grandeur, on the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how can we do that? We can do that through the greatest ayah which is mentioned in the noble Quran. Allah says,
الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم.
Allah, there is no deity worthy of worship other than Him. Al-Hayy, the ever-living, the eternal, the infinite. Al-Qayyum, the one who runs this universe. The one who runs His whole creation.
لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم.
Neither does a tiny slumber nor a deep sleep ever overtake Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ.
Every single atom, every single molecule that is in the heavens and the earth belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ.
Who has the guts? Who has the power? Who has the strength? Who has the courage to intercede in front of Allah except with His permission?
يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم.
He knows that which is before them and that which is after them.
ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء.
And they, Allah is talking about mankind, they do not know a thing other than which Allah has willed for them to know.
وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض.
The point I want to mention. Allah's footstool encompasses the seven heavens and the seven earths. Allahu Akbar.
وَلَا يَؤُودُهُ حِفْظُهُمَا وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ.
Seven heavens, seven earths. Maintaining them, running them, looking after them does not tire or fatigue Allah the Almighty in any way. He is the most high, the most great. Now look at the verse, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam.
وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ.
The footstool of Allah encompasses the seven heavens and the seven earths. The footstool of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look, I'm not talking about the arsh. I'm talking about the kursi. The arsh is something else, the kursi is something else. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says,
ما السماوات السبع في الكرسي إلا كحلقة ملقاة على أرض فلات.
الله أكبر. Seven heavens, seven earths, in comparison to the kursi of Almighty Allah, the footstool of Almighty Allah, is like a tiny iron ring flung in a vast barren desert. The comparison. This is just a creation of Allah. Seven heavens and seven earths. The hadith does not end there. The comparison goes on. Now the kursi with the arsh of Allah. Once again, the kursi which is so great and so grand that the seven heavens and the seven earths are like a tiny ring. Now that very kursi, that footstool of Almighty Allah has become the tiny ring. Now that in comparison to the arsh of Allah, the throne of Almighty Allah is like a tiny iron ring flung in a vast desert. So my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, the question I pose to you, if the arsh of Allah is so great, think about the owner of that arsh, the possessor of that arsh, the one who has infinite strength, Allahu Akbar. Just imagine how Allah would be. We cannot imagine. Our minds cannot perceive. All we can perceive is the grandeur of the arsh. And that's it. Our mind stops there. Our intellect stops there. We cannot go further. Allahu Akbar, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. So don't you think that we need to bring in the fear of Allah? The more we reflect on the grandeur, the more we reflect on the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we should shiver. We should tremble in front of Allah. Such a great creator. Such a powerful creator. There is no other being, no other deity worthy of worship other than Him. لَا مَعْبُودَ بِحَقٍ فِي الْوُجُودِ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. We prostrate, we fear none other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We fear none. We don't fear any government. We don't fear any president. We don't fear any king or any monarch for that matter except Allah the Almighty. We do not bow down, we do not place the highest point of our body on the ground except for Allah the Almighty. We do not worship saints, we do not worship graves, none of this. We worship Allah the Almighty. Allah the Almighty. Allah Himself, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, now He describes Himself in the very first ayah of the Quran.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين.
All praise be to رب العالمين. رب العالمين. Just leave it there, pause. I'll come back to that. الرحمن الرحيم. The most merciful, the most beneficent. Maliki Yawm al-Din. The King of the Day of Judgment. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, in regard to Rabb, Rabbul Alameen, the Lord of the worlds, we translate it. But the word Rabb is connected to the name Allah, and I have to address it. The word Rabb is a short term or a short name, but it has a very, very deep meaning. It has a deep meaning, a very large picture behind it, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Scholars mention that there are so many meanings to the word Rabb. Allahu Akbar. Allah is our Rabb. Now just imagine, just as how the word Allah has manifested in so many actions, we say Allah in so many our adiyah, our salawat, our prayers. Likewise Rabb. Look at the dua.
رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنٍ.
So many adi'ya in the Quran.
رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا وَلِوَالِدَيْنَا وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَوْمَ يَقُومُ الْحِسَابُ.
Now take your 5 times salah.
رَبَّنَا وَلَكَ الْحَمْدُ سبحان ربي الأعلى وبحمده سبحان ربي العظيم.
Everywhere Rabb. It is an equally important name, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. It is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala introduced Himself to us in Alamul Arwah. Do you remember?
Allah asked us, أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ.
Am I not your Rabb? What did we say? Our covenant, our pledge.
قَالُوا بَلَى.
We said, of course, Ya Allah, you are our Rabb. This is how Allah introduced Himself to us. Likewise, what is the question in the qabr? What is the question in the qabr?
مَنْ رَبُّكْ.
Who is your Rabb? Who is your Lord? Now coming to the translation of Rabb, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, the list is endless. The list is endless. Creator, nourisher, cherisher, sustainer, provider, protector, curer. The list goes on. The meanings for Rabb, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. And likewise, this name has been frequently mentioned in the Quran and the Hadith. It has been mentioned 500 times in the Quran, in the Noble Quran. 500 times. In the Noble Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam,
وَمَا تَوْفِيقِي إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ.
Just a final point and then I'll wrap it up inshaAllah.
وَمَا تَوْفِيقِي إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ.
That the facilitation to do good deeds, you coming and sitting here, me talking to you, we listening to good things, we listening to Allah and His Rasul. This tawfiq is known as facilitation. This tawfiq, this facilitation to do good deeds, this facilitation to make it to the masjid for salah, this facilitation that helps us to listen to good things, talk good things, amr bil ma'roof wa nahy anil munkar. It is all from Allah, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. We should not become slaves to our own self-confidence. Now today everything in the world is about self-confidence. Yes, you need to think positive and not negative, but don't become slaves to your own self-confidence. Because it is not your talent, it is not your capability, it is not your intellect that brought you here. It is not any of that. It is the tawfiq of Allah.
It is the facilitation of Almighty Allah that He brought you here. There are so many people outside. I'm not talking about the lecture, about Salah, which is fard. It is fard. There are many of us outside. Allah did not bestow upon them the facilitation to make it for Salah. But Allah chose us. What did we do? What did we do for that? Have we got any ranks for that? Allah chose us. It is not our own self-confidence. It is not our own willpower. It is all from Allah the Almighty, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. And why I mention that is because from the word Rabb comes tarbiyah. Rabb, tarbiyah. Tarbiyah is the upbringing, the nurturing. Allah is al-murabbi. Allah is al-murabbi. Likewise, y'all are murabbi to your own children. Y'all are murabbi to your own families. Allah is the murabbi of all of us. Just as how Allah was the murabbi to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah was the murabbi to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Three instances. First instance, Allah says, وَمَا تِلْكَ بِيَمِينِكَ يَا مُوسَى. O Musa, alayhi salatu wasalam, what is in your hand? He goes on to describe what is in his hand. قَالَ هِيَ عَصَايَ أَتَوَكَّأُ عَلَيْهَا وَأَهُشُّ بِهَا عَلَى غَنَمِي وَلِيَ فِيهَا مَآرِبُ وَلِيَ فِيهَا مَآرِبُ أُخْرَى. Ya Allah, I do this, I do that, I pluck leaves with it, I lean on it. He starts mentioning the benefits of his asa. Allah says, قَالَ أَلْقِهَا يَا مُوسَى. Throw it, O Musa, alayhi salatu wasalam. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam throws it, and what happens? It becomes a snake. A vicious snake. And mankind, the nature of man, he does not know what he does in fear. He runs, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, takes to his heels. Allah says, قَالَ خُذْهَا وَلَا تَخَفْ. Don't fear. O Musa, don't fear. Hold it. سَنُعِيدُهَا سِيرَتَهَا الْأُولَى. And we shall make it go back to its earlier state. Make it back an asa. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam catches it. This is the first instance. Second, now this is tarbiyah. Allah is nurturing Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, taking him from strength to strength. The next instance is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders him to go to Fir'aun. Orders him to go to Fir'aun. Today, we being a minority, we find it difficult to stand up for the truth. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, all alone, a tyrant psychopath, Fir'aun, messed up. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks Musa alayhi salatu wasalam to go to him and give him da'wah. And then what happens? He organizes what? A magic competition. Where Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was once again asked to throw his staff. He feared. Allah said, don't worry, we'll take care of it. And what happens? Musa alayhi salatu wasalam's staff, Allah, through the will of Allah, the power of Allah, it becomes a miracle that overpowers the illusionary magic of those magicians. And the final instance, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, that proves to us the fruit of this tarbiyah. The final instance where Musa alayhi salatu wasalam and his qawm, they're rushing. The army of Fir'aun is behind them.
فَلَمَّا تَرَاءَ الْجَمْعَانِ قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُوسَى إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ.
The two parties, تَرَاءَ الْجَمْعَانِ, they're looking at each other now. The army of Fir'aun can see the Banu Israel and Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. They're within grasp. And then أَصْحَابُ مُوسَى, the people of Musa, they say, إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ. We're finished. We're done. They're going to overtake us. And now what is the reply of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam? Allahu Akbar. This evil monarch is behind him. This is not a snake anymore now. But look at the iman. Look at the fruit of the tarbiyah.
قَالَ كَلَّا إِنَّ رَبِّي مَعِيَسْ إِنَّ مَعِيَ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ.
He says, never. Indeed, my Lord is with me. He says these words now. With confidence, no fear anymore. No fear at all. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then reveals to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, فَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى مُوسَىٰ أَنِضْرِبْ بِعَصَاكَ الْبَحْرِ.
Allah reveals to him, O Musa, strike the ocean with your staff. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals this to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah divides the ocean. Allah divides the ocean and makes a dry path for Musa alayhi salatu wasalam and his qawm to pass by. Scholars mention that the division was so great that even the animals that were in the sea at that time divided into two. The miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even the fish, whatever was in the sea, divided itself into two. Everything was standstill. Just picture it. Two great walls on both sides of water. It is as if you're walking through an aquarium. You can see water on both sides, the fish into two, in half. Allah. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam crosses over. Fir'aun thinks that it is due to my power, it is because of me that the sea has parted. He steps in confidently and Allah brings back the water and drowns them. This is the fruit of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bringing up, nurturing Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, taking him from strength to strength, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam.